Hollywood heavyweight Tom Cruise lit up Sydney's Darling Harbour last night at the Australian premiere of Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning Part 1. Joined by his co-stars, Cruise had more than one thing to celebrate, commemorating his 61st birthday in blockbuster fashion. Who are you here to see today?
Mr. Tom Cruise.
And why would you be doing that?
Because who wouldn't? I mean, it's Tom Cruise.
Bradley.
Yes.
Last time I saw you, you were front row waiting to see Margot Robbie at the Barbie fan event last week.
That's right.
And you were the only person there wearing a Slipknot hoodie.
Damn right.
And that's because you'd done your research.
Of course.
Why did you wear your Slipknot hoodie?
Because Margot's a maggot.
So true.
Tom Cruise, you complete me.
Happy birthday to you, Tom.
Have you come to see Tom Cruise today?
Bella Vista.
Well, that's not too bad. Anyone come from interstate or are you? Oh, where did you guys come from?
We came from Adelaide.
We came from
Melbourne.
Melbourne. From where? China?
Yes.
From Lebanon.
What, just to see Tom Cruise?
Yeah.
He turned 61 today. Can you believe that?
Fantastic.
Looks pretty good, doesn't he?
You wouldn't pick it.
Tom Cruise is my daddy.
Really? Movie premieres do not come any bigger than this. Tom Cruise here for the 7th installment of the Mission Impossible franchise, which has so far made more than $5 billion worldwide. I'm thrilled to be here, the fans are here, but I'm missing something. I'm missing something. Help me out, boys. What am I missing? Good to see you.
How are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
Very well,
thank
you.
Smart. You got a coat on this evening?
Well, last time I saw you, we were on the upper deck of an aircraft carrier in San Diego, and we were melting.
Yeah, I know. That was hot.
Hey, if you've got to work on your birthday, this is the way to do it.
Nah, this isn't work to me. This is the pleasure. This is why we do it. This is why I make my films for audiences, and I love these moments. And I feel fortunate because I've spent my birthdays, most of them on movie sets or promoting films, so it's a real privilege.
What does it mean to you to see this number of people turn out? And they all have something special to say to you. I watched the interactions. How does that actually make you feel?
It's magical. You know, I don't ever expect it. And, you know, when I'm making films, I'm dreaming of these nights and sharing it with audiences. And then to have it on my birthday, it's just very special. It really is magical. I love it.
It's been a long time, fam.
Tom, this movie is epic. So many moments, death-defying stunts. Yes. We travel all around the world.
I know.
Are you proud of it? What's it like when you first see it finished up on the big screen?
You know, we're constantly working on it, so it's been years because of all the things that happened. So
There were a few things that tried to derail you.
All through its different iterations, it's wonderful when it finally finished. We finished the film just about 4 days before the first premiere in Rome. So we're working on it right to the last second.
This was like the usual experience of making a film times 10, just right. Because it took longer, it was a big challenge. You know, sometimes we thought it felt like a Mission Impossible to get it made, so to finally see it and see how amazing it is, I mean, it was such a joy. I'm so proud of this movie. It's an absolute quintessential summer blockbuster.
What was the best thing about being in this movie for you?
To work with Christopher McQuarrie and Tom Cruise.
Because you've known Tom for a while.
Yeah, we've been working together for a few years now on this specific movie, but I was a huge fan of their work already, you know? And being a part of Mission Impossible was one of my dreams, so it's really special to be here right now.
What do you expect me to do?
Well, just, you know, jump.
Does Christopher McQuarrie tell you what he's going to do with Benji, or do you just get to read it on the page and be a bit surprised by it all?
We go for dinner, like, before we shoot a movie, and he tells me all his plans. And then they all change. So, you know, I just hold on. I get on the train and hold on.
Hang on.
Good to see you again, Christopher.
How are you? An institution.
See, that's what he calls me. That's my nickname from Christopher McQuarrie, and yes. I'm going to own it. I love it.
Institution.
And you mean that in a nice way,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
Hey, it's great to see you. What's the response been from fans tonight?
Extraordinary. It's really lovely being back here. We love Australia. And don't get here often enough.
Well, one of the Mission Impossible films many moons back was filmed here, so I guess we're off the list for the future. You don't return to places, do you?
We've actually gone back to Norway and Abu Dhabi a couple times, and some, you know, a lot in Australia has changed, and a lot of it, I lived here, and I've traveled around the country, so I know there's a lot more to it.
So what you're saying is?
Anything is possible.
People are chasing us.
Yes, they are. You're driving.
What was the welcome like for you as the new girl?
A little bit of a hazing situation going on. I'm not gonna lie.
What did they do?
Well, they were just like, you know, they're a bit like, what do you got? But all within tongue and cheek.
So there was someone there who would tell you where the good biscuits were in craft services.
Ooh, you aren't allowed biscuits, are you kidding me? That amount of sugar would send me high as a kite and then I'll be crashing by lunchtime.
I thought you needed it to drive like you drive.
Actually, the opposite. Sugar makes me cranky.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, it makes me kind of a bit high like a five-year-old, and then I kind of need to sleep. So there's no way that could have passed my lips.
What do you think of the Australian sense of humour? Is there something unique about us here?
I think it's very similar to ours, you know. I mean, we're sort of cousins, global cousins. I just watched Colin from Accounts, which I really love.
Isn't it great?
Yeah, yeah. I thought that was such a funny show. And it felt very sort of similar to Spaced, which is a show that I did back in the 90s, which also had a dog called Colin. And I felt that it was like we were sort of, you know, cousins.
Simpatico.
As well. Very much so, yeah.
You've told me before that one of your dreams as a little boy was to travel the world and make movies. And I have to say thank you.
That was probably the dream.
The dream.
Yeah, I wanted to fly airplanes and go to space and all that stuff. So
you're going to go to space? That's coming.
Yeah, that's coming. I fly jets and airplanes and...
I know, but I have to thank you because you doing that has meant I've got to travel the world too. Because I was at the Burj Khalifa for Ghost Protocol.
Right. Oh,
I was on the aircraft carrier.
Burj Khalifa, that was fun.
Mate, I'm looking out that window, going, how on earth did you do that?
I know. That was tricky.
So thank you, because I've got to travel the world too, Tom. I mean, it's amazing. Thanks to you.
Thank you for coming along on the ride.
I wouldn't miss it.
I say Hakuna.
I say Matata.
Hakuna. Matata. Hakuna. Matata.
I saw you singing with James Corden and The Lion King. Is there a movie musical in your future?
I have been working on a musical.
You have?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I always have about five films that we're working on at the same time.
I was probing you the other day when we chatted about what exactly some of the other plans you and Tom have.
Yes.
You know, I was throwing about musicals and Les Grossman and those sort of things, and I wasn't getting far. I just want to see if I can get any further with you today.
I'm afraid I'll be just as cryptic now as I was then.
Yeah. I love the idea of a musical. Would you ever entertain it?
When we did Fallout, we originally introduced Vanessa Kirby's character with a musical number.
Did you?
Yeah, that was kind of a dry run at my attempt to do music. Everything you see in all of these movies is just us rehearsing for something bigger down the road. So it's coming. It's in the cards.
You have filmed an Australian Mission Impossible before. McHugh said the country's changed a bit. Would you think of revisiting filming another mission here?
No, this country's absolutely stunning. Just looking at the Opera House and the different light, it's just such a beautiful city and a beautiful country. I'd love to come back and film here. And now there's so much production going on.
Yes.
When I made MI2, we were the first, really, you know, you had The Matrix, but they didn't shoot that for Australia.
No.
Mission at that time, this was a, you know, we had the Olympics that came, and it was a real calling card for this city and this country.
So you might come back, eh?
Not might, I'd love to. Love it.
We're going to see part two of Dead Reckoning next year.
Yeah.
When will you finish that?
Your guess is as good as mine. With everything being as unpredictable as it is, I could tell you, and that probably wouldn't be the case. But we hope to finish shooting it later this year, end of the beginning of next year.
We're finishing the next Dead Reckoning Part 2, and there's plenty of mountains to climb. A lot happening.
You're going to space at some point.
Yeah. Yep. It's busy. We got a lot of things we got to get done. So I got to finish the next film, then we got to move on. A lot of things.
Well, I'm going to wish you a very happy birthday. I got you a little badge. It's important for people to know it's your birthday.
Oh, good. Yeah, it's my birthday. Thank you very much.
The birthday boy had one more surprise up his sleeve because he was determined to finish this Australian tour with a bang.
It looked like a hell of a night.
It was an incredible... He was on the red carpet talking to fans for about 3 hours, not a word of a lie. He saw every single fan, and there were thousands there. He spent time with every single fan that had come out there.
That's what a superstar does, isn't it?
Yeah, and a lot of them had got tickets to go to see the film as well, which is just incredible. He does so much planning, so much work into each movie. And to hear that he's got one coming up in space, a musical, and all these other ones coming up as well, all with Christopher McQuarrie, who's his close working partner.
That's why they're so great.
I know.
I was wondering what you were going to get him for his birthday.
I was racking my brain because I'd asked all the rest of the cast what I should get. And, you know, Simon Pegg said a flower from the beach. And I thought, yeah. I can't do
it. I thought you were going to make that Sanchoy Bell for him.
That would have been good.
Next time.
It's messy, though. It would have got on my cream coat, apparently. I thought the badge was a nice touch.
Oh, I thought it was great.
And he kept it. He hung around with it, which is great. So Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning Part 1 opens this Saturday, July the 8th, which is, of course, an unusual day of the week for movie opening in Australia. We usually open on Thursdays, but... Yeah, see it on the big screen and see it over and over again. Don't forget, Steven Spielberg said Tom Cruise saved cinema. Well, he's done it again.